Now, we already know that we'll be getting a fifth season of My Hero Academia, which was revealed in the post-credit teaser at the end of the season 4 finale. We obviously have a while to wait till the fifth season becomes an animated reality, but here's what we do know about the forthcoming season based on the manga. The anime series does a very good job of following the manga and adapting the various story arcs. So the best way to figure out what's in store for us is by turning the pages of the manga. Just how far into the upcoming arcs will they explore? Which arcs will they cover in season 5? And what's likely to be revealed about some of our favorite characters? Well, that's exactly what we're about to explore right now. So if you don't mind some speculative spoilers, then you're in for a treat. But if you do, well, you've been warned. Let's go.
There are no combat points rewarded for taking on that humongous villain, but there is opportunity.
Season 4 of My Hero Academia basically covered about 4 major arcs from the manga: the 8 Precepts of Death arc, the Remedial Course arc, the UA School Festival arc, and the Pro Hero arc. Within those stories, both Overhaul and Gentle were the villains introduced and defeated. Now, the anime pretty much stuffed a lot of chapters into the final few episodes of Season 4, so it's likely Season 5 will expound upon some of the key moments within the Pro Hero arc before moving into the next storyline within the Joint Training arc. Now, based on the manga, the Joint Training arc sees more character exploration and self-discovery for our heroes. Now, some of them will discover new abilities like Deku and his Black Whip, and Fumikage with his Black Fallen Angel, which gives this Birdman the ability to fly. Go figure, right? The return of a former rival for Deku, Hitoshi Senso, will also rear his head during this particular storyline. So based on that prophetic dream Deku had at the end of season 4, the Joint Training arc is definitely happening in season 5. And chapter 213, Realm of Souls, is where Deku will find out even more about the abilities within One For All from the OG Black Whip wielder himself, Daigoro Banjo. Now, this is a pivotal moment in the manga, and it certainly will be in the anime, as it's revealed these vestiges can carry on full-on conversations with Deku and give him important information to aid him in properly wielding One For All. Now, it's similar to when a Jedi dies, you know, they live on within the Force, but in this case, they live on within the heart of the wielder of One For All, which probably has more abilities than the Force does. You know, not that I'm trying to, you know, start a debate between quirks and the Force in the comment section, but I am. Which one do you guys prefer, Star Wars or Boku No Hero? Let me know. So, Deku will discover Black Whip, the Joint Training arc will be explored. These things are certain and a given based on what we've seen in the final episode of season 4. But there's also a very, very shocking revelation that'll soon be revealed, which technically happened in the final chapters of the Pro Hero arc, but it makes sense to have this revealed early on in season 5 as opposed to having it revealed in the back end of season 4, and that's Hawks' true allegiance. Is he friend, foe, or playing both sides? Things we know for certain will be revealed in season 5 of My Hero Academia. Hawks will be revealed to be a double agent, working undercover for the pro heroes to attain as much information as he possibly can from inside the League of Villains. Now, chapter 191 hit manga fans hard when it revealed good guy Hawks consorting with bad boy Dobby, who conspired to orchestrate the entire fight between Endeavor and the high-end Nomu. Now, Hawks, of course, is trying to get in good with the League of Villains to bring them down from the inside, and if you're all caught up on the manga, you know just how far down the rabbit hole this entire thing will go. Manga readers know Hawks' reasoning for doing what he did, and if you fast forward to the Paranormal Liberation War arc, he's redeemed himself, surely, or at least in my opinion. But you know what? While we're back mentioning the story arcs, is there potential for the My Hero Academia anime series to cover more than just the Joint Training arc? The thing with many anime shows based on a manga is that you have to do a decent job of fitting in as many chapters within a short period of time. Now, season 4 managed to cram in 4 story arcs in their 25 episode run. Now that's roughly 72 chapters of the manga. Now this is just speculative, but based on what they've done in the past and in previous seasons, they'll more than likely cram in a similar amount of story arcs, potentially rolling in the last few chapters of the Pro Hero arc into the entirety of the Joint Training arc, then delving into both the Metal Liberation Army arc and the Endeavor Agency arc. Now the inclusion of the Endeavor Agency arc would be wishful thinking at this point, as that's just a mere single story before the current one we're reading in the manga. Now, they'd likely save any deep exploration of the Endeavor Agency arc and the Paranormal Liberation War arc for the sixth season, where we'll likely be far ahead with a couple more chapters by then in the manga. Now, for me, the joint training arc in the manga was a necessary filler to advance the characters and see how much they've all accomplished throughout their rigorous training. I mean, think about it, guys. We see Deku and Fumikage discover new abilities. Bakugo and Todoroki get their hero's license. They've each evolved, and we get to see that happen. Sometimes, you know, you need some filler to, you know, well, fill in the gaps as it pertains to character development. I'd rather see it than to just hear about it. But the manga at this particular point doesn't pick up until the Meta Liberation Army arc, which is likely what the bulk of season 5 of the anime will tackle. It's where we're introduced to Destro's son, Redestro, the founder of the Meta Liberation Army. Now, his goal is to get rid of the League of Villains, as such, fuels a back and forth battle between the two opposing forces. Now, with that comes more character development, and we get to find out more about some of the villains in the League of Villains. The Meta Liberation Army arc is a great juxtaposition to the previous one, the Joint Training arc, in the sense that it shows how our favorite villains interact with each other outside of the battlefield. Not only that, but the Meta Liberation Army arc also features glimpses of moments in the villains' pasts that broke them, broke their spirit, and set them down the dark path of villainy, like the very gruesome and sad reality of Shigaraki's backstory. My favorite chapter during the Meta Liberation Army arc is My Villain Academia for that very reason. It's the chapter that initiates the shift in storytelling from the hero's side to the villains. It'll be interesting to see how season 5 will approach the Meta Liberation Army arc and all the twists and turns that particular story arc contains. So it's a very, very safe bet that season 5 will contain both the Joint Training arc and the Meta Liberation Army arc, because those stories provide more character development on both the hero and villain sides of the spectrum. Now, based on the structure of how they've adapted the arcs and chapters of the manga in the past to the anime, we can only guess that they'll touch upon the end of an agency arc where we'll see Shoto, Deku, and Katsuki begin their work studies under the tutelage of Endeavor. Well, either way, you know what, guys? Season 5 of My Hero Academia is going to be awesome. Shoto! So what do you guys think? How far into the manga is My Hero Academia going to dive into come season 5? Now, how far would you like them to go in the anime? And what do you hope to see? Sound off in the comment section down below. And for more anime, keep watching IGN.